Hi, it's Joy, and today I'm going to be watching Andor Season 1, Episode 10, One Way Out. Which I'm hoping means one way out of the prison, and that he's going to take that this episode. I love the show. It is just such an interesting look at the galaxy at this point in time, at Cassian's character, and I'm excited to see where it goes next. A reminder that you can find the unedited version of this reaction on my Patreon, and let's go! You'd think there'd be, I suppose there's only one way out of the facility, so yeah, otherwise, I was literally about to say, you'd think there'd be another way for them to get the body out, but then I was like, no, there's only one way out, that's the whole point, and that's what the episode's called.
Tomorrow. We can't wait. We'll never have a better chance.
You sound insane.
No, listen to me.
He does.
They don't have
but there's
Lysgards, and they
good reason.
There'll never be Lysgards on tomorrow. You know that!
On program!
Every day we wait, they get stronger.
On program, though.
Might be wise to have a plan.
We have a plan!
Even the fact that they wrote out that long chat before they got on program.
Proceed directly to your cell.
Kino.
We will have immediate facility compliance.
He's been desperately looking at his days. The light was at the end of the tunnel. There is no light. This is the only way out.
I don't believe it. He's only a doctor. They would never tell him.
No one is getting out!
Fuck. Push people to breaking point. They will break.
So let's get our heads back in our cells and start figuring this out.
Mm-hmm. He does make a very good rebel.
What will it cost?
My fee?
We assume it's a percentage of funds transferred.
I want no fee. Money means very little to me at this point. I have a 14-year-old son. I'd like to bring him with me.
He was talking about marriages.
You can't be serious. What makes you think I approve of that tradition?
Our position sometimes makes decisions for us, don't you find?
Senator, Jesus Christ, is she willing to potentially sacrifice her daughter for the rebellion?
Is that your only... I'm not thinking about it.
That's the first untrue thing you've said. It's been
gosh, I love how this show really brings out the fact that starting a rebellion isn't just sunshine and rainbows, and it isn't like, we're the good guys, we never have to cross any boundaries, because that's not how the world works.
Stop wasting time.
At least he does risk himself.
I want out. Don't care how.
I'm dead. I'm dead. Hey, hey, pretend to be dead. Don't die till you put up a fight.
Just keep calm. As calm as possible. Which won't be very calm, but... Almost coming. Fuck. Is the idea they all short circuit the floor?
You man on the floor, hold your positions.
Here we go.
What'd you say to me?
Distraction. Now. Fuck. Yes, new man. You get that guard. I really hope you're not like a murderer or a rapist or something. Okay, well now I kind of hope you are a murderer or a rapist. This is your only chance at a life. He is just a rebel. Standing up against injustice. It worked!
We have a situation on five.
Let's hope all of these guys, everyone who escapes, is like Cassian, completely innocent. Or at least guilty of a minor crime. Because I say so. Oh, he was so desperate to escape. They're doing so well. Armed they are. There were boots. I would have those boots on. Like, those boots right there would be on my feet.
Kino, come on! One way out! Come on, fight!
Burn a firewall around it. Try the whole level. Make the episode.
Jesus Christ.
It's too late.
On program! Now!
Yep. This is it.
Tell him what to do.
All the floors are cold.
He trusts him.
Wherever you are, right now, get up. Stop the work. Get out of your cells. Take charge and start climbing.
And I would rather die trying to take them down than giving them what they want.
Yeah. He is inspirational, Cassian.
They fried 100 men. There is one way out. Right now.
You see someone who's confused, someone who is lost.
You get them moving, and you keep them moving until we put
be
this
band together.
Place
yeah.
Us.
One way out.
So much for helping each other. Yeah. Jump and we'll help you. Jump and we'll grab you and we'll pull you along. Is he working with the rebellion? Another brave soul if he is.
Your daughter, healthy, beautiful. You must be pleased.
It's showing he's keeping tabs on him.
They got lucky we don't build on luck.
He's very crafty.
We know that there's a raid planned on the power station at Spellhouse. If Krieger attacks, they'll be waiting.
And if he doesn't, they'll know something's amiss.
They'll be slaughtered.
Jesus.
50 men. You're worth more than that.
You have to warn them.
Jesus. This, like, you can see that people who, a lot of people who join the rebellion are like this guy. They genuinely want to do the right thing, and they want to save lives, and they want to do good. And then you've got people like Axis, who is looking at the bigger picture and is like, yeah, we need to crack a few eggs to make an omelette. And I kind of think we shouldn't be cracking the eggs, but I get it. I do understand that kind of way of thinking. Things aren't black and white. It's not easy to win this kind of rebellion. Sometimes you have to do bad things, but it's not easy watching. And I don't really agree, but I also understand it and don't really know what else they could do, because he's kind of right. Having this guy's intel is so invaluable. But at the same time, is it worth sacrificing 50 good people?
I can't do this anymore. I'm a father now. I had no idea how it would feel.
Please don't walk out onto the ledge, because I think he'll throw you off.
You love your daughter. Krieger's men will be dying to make sure she has a father.
Jesus Christ.
You're trapped, Lonnie.
How is he meant to look at that baby girl?
It's no pleasure in
knowing
saying,
this.
But you're going nowhere.
This is a dark look at the rebellion.
I sacrificed.
I've given up all chance at inner peace. I made my mind a sunless space. I share my dreams with ghosts.
He is got
I
a
wake
very
up every day to an equation I wrote 50
very
years
big
ago.
Ego.
For which there's only
he's not entirely
truth.
Wrong.
I'm damned for what I do. My anger, my ego,
he's
my
honest,
willingness
though.
To yield, my eagerness to fight. I need all the heroes I can get.
This is surely a sign that he might be about to crack, and that is far worse for you. Oh, did the guy not make it? They want a good swim. And how many of them are still running? But they're out of the prison, that is something. Okay, so this episode was excellent in that they escaped from the prison, and I loved the way it was pulling everybody together. The message was, don't leave a man behind. If you see someone struggling, grab him. The reality was kind of trample over your fallen friend to get out, but the message was nice. I'm really sad that the guy who was like the head of the group didn't escape. Like, I think potentially if someone hadn't shoved Andor off in their eagerness to escape, Cassian would have been like, we'll drag you. Because even if they don't know the, like, I mean, I don't know it. I think like you grab someone's chin and then you're like, I'm not the best swimmer, so I wouldn't be the one to do it. But, you know, a couple of them could have grabbed an arm each and held his head up, and they could, yes, maybe they'd have got caught, but I feel like they would have potentially tried. Did he just stand there and get recaptured, or did he jump in and drown? Like, I don't know what's worse. So that's heartbreaking. I suppose they didn't know what the prison looked like from the outside because they'd literally never seen it. They didn't know the way out was swimming. And the idea that this place was just taking people, the Empire's giving them their sentences, jump like stupid sentences for crimes they shouldn't do, putting them into the system and they would never leave. Yes, in this case it's very literal, but I also feel like it is emblematic of a real problem in society, which is people often, disproportionately, people from minorities will be given harsh sentences for crimes, and then once you're in the system, once you've gone to prison, your opportunities dry up and you end up in that cycle of that life instead of being able to have a future, being given a second chance, being given fair treatment that you would get if you were rich or white. So I feel like this was a very literal representation of the way the prison system is flawed. In America, I know more about the American system than the UK system, but that's not particularly good. I should learn more. But given how the UK is like, hey US, can we be you? With things like that, I feel like it's also bad here. We definitely need reform, great reform. You know, there are even judges who take pride in the fact that they give harsh sentences and things like that in America. Again, I don't know here how it works because I consume a lot of American television. But I feel like this was a really good way of kind of showing the brokenness of the... Because I don't think anybody would watch this and be like, yes, this is great. But it is just a slightly more dramatic space version of the very real prison system that exists. So them escaping was excellent. Using the, again, the so many like public services or like private prisons or whatever will be understaffed. They will be, you know, part of the reason the quality conditions are so terrible is because the staff are desperate. And so they treat people worse to try and keep them down because they can't bother to pay enough, few more people to work there. Obviously we need prisons, but like there's no reason, like look at Scandinavian prisons and then look at UK and US prisons and there is a difference. But seeing them all escape, the hope for the first time was very heartening, but at the same time it was very it was a lot to kind of think about that, the sentence of like, we're dead anyway, so if I'm already dead I might take the one chance I have at living. It was a lot. I don't know how any of them are going to get off of this planet to, I mean maybe there's like a city 10 miles that way that they could get to and spread the word. I have no idea how many of them escaped. I wonder if we'll ever find out. Cassian obviously did. I don't know how he's going to get off the planet. Right now, I would say my only thought was that Vel could be looking for him and could find him, but she was going home, wasn't she? So I doubt that's the case. I have no idea how he's getting off world, how he's going to find himself back with the rebellion. Them helping him escape this would be one way. Is he going to end up going back to Ferrix and seeing exactly how much it has fallen? Yeah, it's a lot. A lot is happening, so I love watching them escape. Then the shenanigans within the ISB were obviously pretty devastating. They know about this plan, they're going to execute their plan. Finding out about the double agent was excellent. He's a very brave man, and I don't fault him for wobbling. I don't fault him for wanting to leave. Even if he had left, I wouldn't have faulted him for that, because it takes a lot of courage to do that, to, you know, to be part of these things, to walk into that place full of those awful people, hear the awful plans they come up with, be a part of the awful plans, because, you know, ultimately you're doing something that's even better, to go home and hug your wife, kiss your daughter and be like, yeah, I, you know, helped an atrocity today. But it's all for the right reasons. I don't blame him for wavering and for wanting to stop, but I also think deep down he knew he was never going to be told by the rebellion, yeah, it's cool, you don't have to come back. Though I do worry, like, if he's showing this, if he's wavering, if he's beginning to crack, why might they might view him as a liability? Because if he breaks and he says, please, you know, give me leniency, protect, don't punish my family, the rebellion, you know, I contact them, but it could be a trap next time. The more they leave him in when he's wavering, the more dangerous it could be. There was genuinely a point where I thought he was going to walk out onto that bridge and be shoved off, because we don't have loose ends here. Though I suppose a security officer falling to his death in a random part of Coruscant wouldn't look great. The whole thing with, I'm going to call him Axis because I literally cannot know his name. It does not stick in my brain when they've said it. Griffin or something, but Axis. He is terrifying. But he is the darker truth to rebellions. Often revolutions and things like that, they're not pretty. They're not idealistic in their They're idealistic in what they want, they're not idealistic in their method. I do think that potentially you can try a bit harder to do the right thing, but I suppose from what he said, he started out that way and then he crossed too many boundaries and now he just looks at the dark reality of the situation, and that is that things have got to get worse in order for them to get better, because you need to open people's eyes, to just how bad things are in order for them to fight back. The people who are kind of at the moment, they're doing all right, things are quite comfy for them. They aren't aware that 2 years down the line, the Empire's going to decide they want something on that planet. Boom, that comfort's gone and they're no longer in the position to fight back. So it is a messy situation, and it's quite an interesting look at the way the Rebellion is working, because kind of before, I feel like we've really only seen the Rebellion either like in the movies during the like big moments, or in Rebels we follow the Rebellion as it formed, but from the point of view of a crew who were quite independent, who did the right thing and who truly had morals and ideals, and they were able to stick by them because they weren't, at least initially, concerned with the greater picture. And then when they were concerned with the greater picture, things were already in motion and they were able to like veto things that were bad. You know, we got a more noble view of the Rebellion from them. This is the darker side of it. Maybe the truth could be the best course of action would be somewhere in the middle, I don't know, but it is very interesting. Ferrix, his mother's not well, she's reading medication, it's stressful, everything is stressful, I'm stressed. 2 episodes left of this show, it's been very good so far. A reminder that you can find the unedited version of this reaction on my Patreon, and thank you so much for watching.